that you was a shy girl until I made you my girl. Girl, you push me like a big boy till I cuffed you like you did something. You ain't gotta wait for it. You ain't gotta wait for me to give you my love. You ain't gotta wait for it. Things are getting sticky, girl. I think that I'm stuck. I'll admit I'm wrong, but I know that you gon' come for me.
Hey y'all, it's Simply Nikhil here, and today I'm back with another video. Today you guys are coming to work with me. I'm in Louisville, Kentucky. This is my third week at this job. I like to get to know a job and get in the hang of things before I try to do a video. So yeah, I pretty much know where I'm gonna be today and know what I have to do today. I have some pretty interesting things to show you guys. So if you'd like to see a day in the life of me, keep on watching.
You gon' come for me, yeah. Never gonna not hit that. Your love and it's just to me. You gon' come for me, yeah. And every time you hit my phone, you say you need company. I'm a runner boy. 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 I'm a runner boy.
All right, got my still crushing my water, protein syrup, nectar thick, applesauce, cups, made cups, spoons, my little body science stuff, control book, computer. Okay, so right now I am about to get started on my med pass. We do still have to do temperatures and OTs on people, as you can see. We're still masked up, shielded up. So we still have to do temperatures and OTs and select vital signs on my skilled people. So I do that, and then I do my med pass. And I go ahead and get my AP checks as well for the people who are diabetic. Okay, so wait a second. All right, this is my AP check machine. Then I have my lancet test strip. And I have my test strip. I'm an alcohol pad and lancet here. So I just have my list of what I need to get someone up here, and as I get them out of the car, I just click it off. So
take it home.
So I didn't show the narcotics because it had the patient's name on it, but all I did was pop it out, and then as you go, for each narcotic you pull out, you need to sign it off. That's how you keep yourself safe and decrease med errors, and that's another way to make sure you're giving the right med to the right person. Next, I just go back down the list as I'm popping these out to ensure that I have all the medications and to double check the dose.
Like, that's a Claritin 10. I just go extra Claritin 10 and pop it out. So right here, I have my fuel pressure. I only have two fuels to push, but I just open the fuel pack, pour it in, put it in here. I'm done with my med pills. Now I have to give a TV skin test. So here, it's called Tibrosol, and this is what it looks like. You probably can't see, but normally when you give these, you have to put your face and stuff like that. So it will be Tibrosol, and it's the Mantu Sanofi Pasteur. You find the L here, that's the lot number, and the E, that would mean expiration date. You have to know all of that because you have to put that on the paperwork. So all you do is hold on, you will get this, clean it off with an alcohol prep, move that to the side, then you will open your tuberculin syringe. You do 0.1 for a TV skin test. Stick it in, pull up 0.1. No air bubbles. You get 0.1. Get 0.1, pull it up. As you can see here, it's at 0.1. It's like an extra alcohol pad to wipe your skin with. You can mark the borders on your arm. For a TV skin test, you go up in here somewhere. You pull the skin like this, insert this, bevel up. The bevel is, when you look at a needle, the hole you see, that will be pointing upward when you go to put it in the arm. And that's how you do it. Make a little bubble, and that's it. Document the time and the date, and you read it 48 hours after. Okay, so I have an IV to do. So this is an IV piggyback. So I have my flush, and this is the tubing for it, and this is the medication. So what you do here is crack it. Squeeze some of the medicine down in here. Shake it up. Then squeeze to get the medicine to come back up in here. Then, see, just move it all around. And now the medicine is dispersed into the piggy bag. So the next thing you do, I just don't want that to be shown. Open the spike set. Then you see this has the spike set open. So when you roll it down, you clove and the spices. This pops off from here. And then you get the spike twisted in. Then you already can go hang the bag. So when you hang the bag, obviously you're not gonna hang this bag up on the pole. You run these tubing through the machine and our stuff stays, so it's already preset to sit inside. And so then you would get an alcohol pad, wipe the port before you flush, then you would hook up this part to the port, and then you will let it run for however long it's supposed to run. Then you would flush again after the medication is done. Put on the cap that's supposed to be on the port, and then you're done.